monster rally in Shanghai celebrates communism's greatest victory since the coup in Czechoslovakia. 5 months ago, the troops of Mao Tse-tung marched into Shanghai unopposed. That victory was celebrated in July at a gigantic parade in what is today the largest red city in the world, now so isolated that these pictures took 3 months to reach Britain. In those 3 months, the Reds have changed the face of China and brought the world's largest country within the communist empire.
Think of a city where housing is crowded but cheap, the average rent less than $4 a month, where medical care and education are virtually free, where there is no unemployment and no income tax.
All parents everywhere have hopes and dreams for their children. What hopes and dreams do you have for your son?
When he was smaller, I asked him, and he said he wanted to be a soldier. He's very healthy. He can also be an athlete. When he's grown, I hope he can do what the country needs as well as what he likes.
There are no two-car garages either. There are no privately owned cars. And there are no washing machines or freezers or television sets in any of these homes. There are no mortgages or credit cards. There is no self-service, no sales, no advertising, no frozen food, and no inflation. Communism is changing China, but China is also changing communism. The largest state in the world never changes its state of mind completely. We have seen a fragment for a moment, and that moment may already be gone.
In 1979, just 3 years after the death of Mao Zedong, the NBA made its first visit to China when the Washington Bullets took the long journey across the Pacific, flying coach just like everybody else at the time. The 1978 NBA champion served as ambassadors in a country that was introduced to basketball in the late 19th century. 5 years after Naismith invented the game, missionaries brought it to China. A pair of eventual Hall of Famers were the face of the team. Elvin Hayes, the Big E, was a big hit with the young fans. And Wes Unseld joined his teammates on a memorable trip to the Great Wall.
Wigwam belongs to everyone. Whether you clap your hands or beat a drum. My people get a rhythm from a hip-hop.
The Bullets played two exhibition games, one each against the Bay E Rockets and the Chinese national team. Neither gave Washington much of a challenge. But the final score was hardly a factor in the success of this diplomatic mission.
Which is like a guitar, and our Hu is like a bass. Pippa, a Hu.
Shanghai's past reflects the glory not of the Chinese Empire, but of the British Empire. The Chinese would not have built a city this way.
Peepa!
Ooh, 月光照在树上.
80s is the time that the whole country felt the hope and then the promises by the government. We do feel China is happening toward this direction of real openness.
I believe that my greatest strength is my height. Besides that, I'm young and I have lots of energy. I'm also willing to learn as much as I can about the sport. Playing basketball was my own choice. Have you heard the old Chinese saying which mentions that a father will pass on his profession to his son? Well, that's not true in my case. I decided to play basketball because I wanted to, not because of any pressure from my parents. My favorite player is Hakeem Olajuwon of the Houston Rockets, probably because we're both centers. He's great, and I think that he brings a real intelligence to the court in the way he plays basketball. Going forward, he's outstanding, and along with this, he creates so many opportunities for his teammates.
That was my blues, ooh, in Chinese. Yes, that was my blues, ooh, in Chinese. Even like you, I too.
Yao Ming was born and raised in Shanghai, China. At the age of 13, he was accepted onto the junior squad of the city's professional basketball team, the Shanghai Sharks.
He left me. Oh, 你这狠心的人儿，你为什么还不回来呀？ 月光照着，照在树上。
Expectations were already high for the young basketball prospect, and during his second year with the senior squad, he became a key player, averaging over 20 points and 12 rebounds a game before a broken foot derailed his season. In 1999, Shanghai Sharks General Manager, Li Yaomin, negotiated a deal with Evergreen Sports that would have allowed Yao to enter the 1999 NBA draft, whilst also granting the agent 33% of Yao's total career earnings that would have been mostly routed back to the Chinese Basketball Association. With the help of the man who would eventually become Yao's agent, Bill Duffy, the contract with Evergreen was voided and Yao would continue to play in the CBA.
Yao Ming's height is an obvious advantage for us. But on the downside, it has to be said, he's a little bit slow on his feet. We're trying very hard to improve this aspect of his game and are also encouraging him to work on building up his strength. I think Yao Ming will get the opportunity to play in the NBA, and we all hope he goes on to develop his skills there. Everyone involved with this team wants him to achieve his goals.
I think maybe I can. And you know, to play there is every basketballer's dream. If I can maintain my level of performance over the next 2 years, then I think I stand a good chance of playing there at some stage in the next 15 years.
招着我的狼，带他回我身旁。Steve Francis，Anderson，Wall，William，Maurice Taylor，Hakeem。
The Chinese Basketball Association had been dominated by the army team, the Bai Rockets. They were currently led by another young prospect with NBA hopes, Wang Zhizhi. With Yao Ming back to full strength, the Sharks made the 2000 CBA Finals only to be swept by Wang's Rockets.
I love Yao Ming. I first had the privilege of witnessing his brilliance, genius, and humanity in Sydney at the 2000 Olympic Games. And he was 20 years old at the time, and he changed my life. Yao Ming is very much like a John Wooden, a Bob Dylan, a Jerry Garcia, someone who's a very deep thinker, someone who is willing to step out and over the edge. He is a visionary person who is so concerned about the future.
The next year, Yao would win league MVP and guided the Sharks back to the finals, but they were again beaten by the Bai Rockets. 2 days before the deadline for declaring for the 2001 NBA draft, the Shanghai Sharks held a press conference to announce they would not be releasing Yao from his contract with the team. Yao would go on to dominate the league in 2002, averaging almost 30 points, 20 rebounds and 5 blocks. In the playoffs, he averaged almost 40 points, over 20 rebounds and shot over 75% from the floor. The Sharks again faced the Bai Rockets in the CBA Finals. In one game, Yao Ming went a perfect 21 for 21 from the floor. The Rockets found themselves trailing 2-1 as the Sharks had the chance to take the championship in Game 4 on April 19, 2002. Following the Sharks' victory, new general manager, Bei Li, announced that Yao had opened the door to the NBA with his hard work and that the team would no longer stop him from going to play overseas.